All right, in this video, I'm going to talk about how to compare two different sheets, and I want to look up information from one sheet to the other. On this sheet, I have, let's say, all the orders, all right, going down, and on the next sheet, I have the payment information that has come back. Now, not all of the orders have come back, so we want to see if a payment amount has come back, and if it didn't, then we want to know which ones did not come back. So we're going to use something that's called a VLOOKUP. So in this cell, I'm going to type in equals VLOOKUP and then open parentheses. Now, the first parameter here is the lookup value, and that's going to be the cell that you want to try to look up, which is going to be the order ID over here. So I'll click on A2. I'm going to type in a comma. Now, this is where you go to the other sheet. So it's looking for the table array. And I'm going to go to the payment sheet. And we'll highlight this table over here, all the way down. Now, by the way, this table could be many, many columns across and many, many rows down. The thing is, it's really going to look up in the first column. So the value that you're trying to look up has to be in the first column of the table. That's very important. I'm going to type in a comma. Now, for the next parameter, I want to go to the second column right over here. I want to go to the payment information based on that invoice number. So it is really the second column of the table. So I'll type in a comma and then two. It's really looking for which column that you're looking for from that table when you find the appropriate row. And then I'm going to type in another comma for the next parameter. And look what it says. It says if you want an approximate match, type in true. And if you want an exact match, type in false. And I do want to exactly match this because I'm looking for that exact invoice number. And then I close the parentheses. When I hit the enter key, let's see and take a look at the formula. It says equals VLOOKUP, open parentheses, A2, comma, payment, exclamation point, A2 colon B38, comma 2, comma false, close parentheses. So let's break this down again. This is the cell that you're trying to look up. This is where the table is, right? Notice how it's on a separate sheet, and then the exclamation point separates the sheet name and the cell names. That's where the table is. Comma 2, that means when I go to the table and I find the appropriate row, I want to get the second column from the table. And then we have false there, which means we want to do an exact match. Now, this is something that people do all the time, and I'm going to try to copy that down. So I'm going to get the speed fill here in the corner, and I'm going to double click there, so it's going to go all the way down that column. Now, I want to show you kind of a flaw that's here. Notice how this one says A2 through B38, but when I copied it down, this one says A3 through B39, and this one says A4 through B40. So we want to make sure that it always looks at the same range each and every time. And that's actually where you start to use the absolute value type of formula. So what I want to do is I'm going to go back to the first one, and to do the absolute value, I want to type in a dollar sign around the A2 and dollar signs around the B38. And that really makes it an absolute value. Now, that really won't make a difference until I recopy that down to the cells below. So once again, I'm going to do my speed fill. Okay, now see when I go to the next couple cells, they still say A2 through B38. I want that to be an absolute value. So let's see if it's really coming up with the right information. It's telling me that for 10248, the payment amount is 144. So I'm going to go to cell. I'm going to go to the sheet that's called payment, and let's go back to the top. And 10248 does say 40, 144. So it's finding the right amount. Let's go back and find another one. All right, here's 10256, and it says the payment amount there was 4819.4. So let's go here, 102.56, 4819.4, and that's correct. So it is finding the right amount. Now let me show you something. For those that have found the payment amount, it puts the payment amount in there. But let's scroll down a little bit. Now, see where it says NA? NA means it did not find that invoice number on the other sheet. So that payment did not come over. So when you're comparing your two sheets and you use the VLOOKUP like I just described, if you have any that return an NA for you, that really means that it did not find that on the other sheet. So using the VLOOKUP, this is how we can compare two different sheets between Excel 2010, actually to work in Excel 2007, 2010, 2013, and Excel 365.